What's up, guys? This is Champ, and today I have the full Black Ops 2 buried Maxis Easter egg, and I guess let's just jump right into it. The first step of the Maxis Easter egg requires you to find four parts that are scattered around the map. The first part is just going to be in that corner next to Juggernog. Once you get each part, you'll want to come to this Maxis kind of little shrine here. It is actually the noose, and you're going to place each part down. The second part is going to be the antenna, and it's going to be located in the horse stables right there. Again, you're going to make your way again to the noose and just place it down. Every time you get a bit closer to completing the noose, Maxis will actually tell you. The third piece is going to be located in the church, as you can see right there. We're going to grab it. It is going to be the battery, so we're going to come and place it on the Maxis noose once again. He'll say we're 3/4 of the way done. The fourth piece is in the gunsmith. I actually had to record this solo just because I did not record it when we were playing earlier, so there it is. And then again, you want to take it to the noose and place it once again. Second step is the ores. What you want to do is get the Paralyzer Wonder Weapon and shoot all of the ores. That'll turn them white. Once you do that, you're going to need the Subsurface Resonator and the Turbine in combination to blow up the orbs. The first one is just right next to the saloon. The second one is located up in the tunnels up here, and it's just going to be right there. The third one is going to be located outside right next to the church. And the fourth one is going to be located behind the mansion, just along this brick wall. Once you do that, that is step number two complete, and we're on to step three. Step three is the lantern step. Once you complete step two, this lantern will start floating around. Just throw a frag at it, and you'll hear Maxis speak.
Good! Now you must secure the lantern to ensure that it is not used to advance Richtofen's plans. The lantern is a vessel for energy. The energy contained within all matter. You must find a method to manipulate the power of the undead. Their energy may provide vital fuel for the lantern. Lest you face corruption from the errant energy, you may need help from a soul already bound to this realm.
The second part of this step is you're going to want to kill zombies. The way we did it is we used the trample steam right next to this orb here. For some reason, that just makes it go quicker. I don't know why. I don't know if the trample steam is the preferred method to do it, but I've heard that if you actually make Leroy mad, he will also help charge the lantern. Or just shooting zombies also do help charge the lantern, so there's many things you can do. This is just the easiest way for us.
Essential to illuminate the words of those who came before you. Their wisdom will show you the way.
Okay, whereas just looking is actually going to be the last part of this step, you're just going to jump on this roof and go over to the lantern and just place it there to add the part.
Only a burst of electricity will have the brute force necessary to release the energy bound to this realm.
Okay, I'm going to do my best to explain this next step because it can get kind of confusing. First of all, there's three lines there. There's three lines of cipher that you have to try to decode. The way we decoded it is you can see the top one was ground butter pits, the second one was dry culture shaft, and the third one was bone orchard vein. There's five different phrases. All of these phrases are located on signs in the mines. And in Maxis's last speech to you, he told you that you're going to need electric punch, which is going to be the Galvan Knuckles, to activate it. So what you're going to do is you're going to try to find similarities in the cipher to try to decode it. There's no 100% guarantee that you're going to be a master at it or anything like that. But as you can see on number three, the fourth one in was an E, and the third last one was an E. So that helps us see that the third last character in the Bone Archer Vein is an E, and the fourth one in the beginning of Bone Archer Vein is an E. So we can see they both look exactly the same, so they're both E's. For the top one, you can see that the T's are the exact same, but you also have to keep in your knowledge that there are spaces. So the spaces in the word actually counts as spaces in the cipher. So you have to always remember there is spaces there, so don't just count the letters, count the space too, as you can see where I marked that out. Once you have your three-phrase combination figured out, you want to make your way up into the caves and punch the signs in that order. That will cause a wisp to spawn, and Maxis will repeatedly tell you to stay as close to it as physically possible. You actually cannot do this at the end of a round. You need zombies, because the zombies are going to give the wisp life here. As you can see, we didn't have any zombies here, so that is going to cause our wisp to slowly die, and as soon as we make it into the room above Juggernog, it slowly fades away, and then we have to restart the process. But all you have to do for that is just go hit the signs again. Okay, we started the round, which is going to give the Wisp more life because it can now absorb energy from the undead or the zombies. The best way to do this is you're going to want to have one person in the bottom of the stables, and you're going to want to have one person just outside the saloon, just so there's more zombies that the Wisp can get life from so it doesn't go out as quickly. The key part of this step is you're going to stay as close as physically possible to it, but right before it reaches the noose, you're going to have a time bomb. The time bomb is the most crucial part. If you don't have it, you've completely screwed yourself. You need to throw the time bomb probably 5 seconds before it hits the noose. I actually kind of screwed up there and hit the wrong button, but it actually still worked out for us. The key part of this is you're going to want to have to go back in time so that you can get a second Wisp. And you're going to do the exact same step again. You're just going to need the second Wisp to do the same thing so you can light up the second light bulb in the noose. Now just repeat that step, get the Wisp, and follow it until it reaches the noose once again. Have one person training in the bottom of the stables and have one person training outside of the saloon. And just follow it till it reaches Max's noose. Okay, once you complete step 4, it will cause 3 sets of 3 bells to spawn in 3 different areas. The 3 areas are going to be the courtroom, which one is on this table right here, one is up by the judge's booth, and the third one is actually going to be on your left right when you walk in the door. The second set of bells is going to be located above the candy shop. The first one's just going to be on that chair. The second one is going to be on this dining room table over here. And the third one is going to be just in the corner right next to the drop. Finally, the last set of bells is going to be located in the top stables. There's just going to be one on this hay bale right here. There's going to be one to my left here on this other hay bale. And the third one's going to be on my right, just straight ahead of me here on this last hay bale. Now proceed to go into the mansion. Once you're in here, you actually see a lever located on this couch. And this is going to be where I have to explain how you're going to use the lever in coordination with the bells. Once you pull the lever, it's going to cause a 9 long series of flashing lights to start on this lever right here. What you're going to want is you're going to want one person in the candy room, one person in the barn, and one person in the courthouse. Now you're going to want to have someone test which light is going to be which. So say you have someone in the courthouse, they test the one that is on the judge's desk and that appears as red 8. So you're going to know red 8 is that, so whenever that light flashes, you can tell that person, hit red 8. And say you have someone in the candy room, it's the one next to that stove there. They hit it, it's green 3, so you tell them green 3, and you have someone in the barn, and it's on that first hay bale, and it's blue 4, then you tell them to hit blue 4, and again, it's going to be a 9 long series of flashing lights, and all you have to do is hit them in the order that they appear. Here's the final part of when we completed the step. This is just the last bell I have to hit here, and it's going to cause that ringing sound, that indication that you've completed the step. Okay, this is step 6. For step 6, you want to make your way to the fountain here. It's going to have a new command called Make-A-Wish. What Make-A-Wish is basically called Sharpshooter. Sharpshooter is 4 different locations where a series of 20 targets are going to all appear. This is a very hard step, so you guys got to be very, very well organized if you ever want to complete this. The targets are going to appear in 4 different locations. The first part is going to be along the side of the mansion house. The second part is going to be located in the saloon. The third part is going to be in front of the candy store. And the fourth set is going to be right next to Juggernog. So you're going to want to have 4 people in each location shooting the targets. And what you want to do is you don't need to have 100% accuracy or anything like that. You can miss targets. It's perfectly fine to do that. I'd like to thank RadAustins27 for allowing me to use the final sequence of the sharpshooter step in this video. His link will be in the description, and go check him out. So you just got to remember you have to get 100% accuracy. It doesn't matter how much you shoot. You can spray as much as you want. The only problem with spraying is, of course, you will burn through your clip a bit faster, and then you have to perfectly time your reloads a bit better. I believe Rad Austin at the end of this actually has his achievements off, but he does go and show you that he's been awarded the achievement. So what you're going to get for completing the Mind Games Easter Egg is you're going to be given perma perks just like we got in Moon. You're going to get all 7 perks, and even if you go down, if you're revived, you're going to maintain all 7 perks. But again, I believe that only lasts for the game, so it's nothing too insanely incredible like that, but there's still more to come. I believe Rad Austin is getting the achievement right now. As you can see, he was just given Quick Revive. He's going to go to his achievement list in a moment, and you will see that he's been awarded Mind Games, which is a 75 gamer score. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like and subscribe, and also go check out Rad Austin's 27, because he's an awesome guy. So go check him out. Peace out, guys. Thanks for watching. Awesome Easter egg.